What a crazy day today was. What's going on, team? It's Ricky with TechBut Solutions here with another video. And what I actually want to pay attention to is /NQ. And if we pay attention to the 1 day, 1 minute chart, this kind of just shows you all the activity that we saw. Market opens here at 6:30, and we were seeing a lot of consolidation. If you're part of the Learn Plan Profit group during our live trading session, it just really wasn't working well during that live trading session. And then things began to become a little bit more clear. And once we broke below this previous support range, all hell just broke loose with /NQ and just began to aggressively sell off. Am I surprised? No. Was this expected? Not 100%. Again, one of the things that I try to remind everyone, and I'm sure all of you guys all know, right, is that no one knows exactly what is always going to happen, right? If anyone did, then again, they would always have an edge on the market. But one of the things that we can always prepare for is becoming aware of previous patterns. And one of the things that we have noticed is that, just like we talked about with two previous videos in a row, yesterday I talked about the NASDAQ making all-time highs and then three reasons on why the stock market could drop. Did this mean that this had to happen today, or that it had to happen yesterday, or that it had to happen next week? No, of course. No one ever knows 100% what is going to happen. Some people get so offended of when, you know, you say that, hey, the market is overbought, it's bound to pull back. I don't say that because I'm trying to predict the future. I am well aware that I, like nobody else, right, can predict the future. But what we can pick up on are trends, our patterns, and at least be prepared so you're not surprised, right? I would hate for someone to enter a position thinking that the market's just going to continue to thrive when it's obviously on the 180-day chart for /NQ, the overall NASDAQ is at all-time highs. So is it wrong to remind people that, hey, don't be afraid to lock in profits? No, just so like today and how it played out, you won't be surprised when it begins to sell off. And it is so great that when direction began to become a little bit more clear, we made an absolute killing on SQs. How did we know that SQs goes up when the market sells off? Again, because we are aware, and it just continued and continued to thrive. One of the things that I want to lastly point out is I do agree with a lot of you that the unemployment report that was sent out today was actually good in the idea that we are making consistent progress in making a steady recovery from the peak of the pandemic. We are still a little bit over 10% with 1.8 million jobs that have been added back. This means that we are almost under 10% unemployment. And the last thing that I want to point out is we are now trading below the 180-day 4-hour time frame. And the reason that this is so important is normally, not always, again, I understand I'm not a fortune teller, but normally when it pulls back and it breaks below the EMA line, it does a very good job correcting itself. This does not mean that the market's going to crash. This does not mean that for investors that you should sell everything. This simply means that it wouldn't be much of a surprise if we correct ourselves back down to the SMA line, or we experience in some form of way a little pullback. It's healthy, right? It's healthy while something is uptrending that it has these little corrections so we can buy more for a good deal and ride the recovery. Buy more for a good deal and ride the recovery. And then you can pick up on either previous resistance levels or just previous patterns and have a better understanding of, hey, it's overbought enough. Maybe it's time to lock in profits so I can give this thing time to pull back a little bit, buy it for a better deal and sell it for a profit. Whatever your plan is, I am just very excited that we are now showing signs of a pullback. Today was the first red day for the overall market, which broke that 5-day green streak. So it had an amazing start to the month of August. But let's be honest, the more that this thing pulls back, the better deals that we can get. All I wanted to do was I wanted to inform you that, hey, it is overbought. Don't be surprised if it pulls back. But also, while and if this thing begins to pull back, maybe start creating a watch list of what stocks you want to buy for a good deal. And if the market continues to rally, as many think that it will, that you set yourself up for success. It's not that anyone can see the future. It's not that anyone knows exactly what is going to happen, but it's just making sure that you do your part in taking advantage of opportunities and also locking in profits when it makes sense. We have a saying within our Learn Plan Profit group that is, I make money in the stock market because I sell early. And trust me, either if you're day trading or even swing trading, especially if you're learning how to trade, it is never a bad idea to lock in profits, to do your part in staying in the green. I really do appreciate you guys' time. Just make sure that you guys also keep a close eye on industrial stocks. There is a lot of talk due to us making a steady recovery from the peak of our unemployment and people are resuming and getting America back into business. This is when we can see a series of different stocks that have been unfortunately devastated due to this COVID-19 slowly and actually begin to make a steady recovery and not just the tech companies actually continue to thrive. I really hope that we earned your thumbs up. Don't forget to stay connected. We do run the largest Facebook group in the world with a little bit over 288,000 members, and that's going to be that first link down below. If you guys want to watch me trade live as soon as Monday, just make sure you guys click that second link down below. You guys can learn a little bit more about the Learn Plan Prof group, and again, watch me be able to trade live as soon as Monday. Like always, team, let's make sure that we end the year on a green note. Take it easy, team.